Hi, welcome to this talk where I'm going to present the NOMAD Artificial Intelligence Toolkit. I will briefly introduce myself. I am Luigi Sbeiro and I work in the NOMAD Laboratory in Berlin. At the NOMAD Laboratory, we maintain the NOMAD Artificial Intelligence Toolkit that is aimed to facilitate the deployment of artificial intelligence onto FAIR material science data that is stored in the NOMAD archive. So let's see why we need such an AI toolkit. A specific feature of the NOMAD AI toolkit is that it allows a direct interaction with the NOMAD archive, where the NOMAD archive is a material science database that, in addition to including data already stored in other material science databases as AFLOW, the Materials Project, and OQMD, it also includes a very large number of data that is uploaded by individual researchers. The NOMAD archive implements the FAIR principles, where, as you know, FAIR stands for findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. And now the NOMAD archive already totals over 100 million data points, which are mainly the results of DFT calculations. This massive amount of data offers the ideal conditions for the deployment of AI. And we can reinterpret the FAIR acronym from this perspective as findable AI ready. So the NOMAD archive contains a very large number of AI ready data. And for this reason, we maintain the AI tool. The NOMAD AI toolkit was conceived for mainly three purposes. And as you might have understood, one purpose is to allow a direct deployment of AI onto data stored on the NOMAD archive. On the other hand, we don't expect all NOMAD users being already proficient or familiar with AI. For this reason, we maintain a number of different tutorials that guide through the most common AI methodologies. Last but not least, the AI toolkit it also has the aim to promote reproducibility of published results. And in fact, you can find in the AI toolkit a number of tutorials that allow to reproduce the main results of papers published in scientific journals. So let's see how we can do all of this. In the AI toolkit, we currently deploy the latest technology used in data science and machine learning. All tutorials are in the format of Jupyter Notebooks that reads the Python language. Docker then allows to deploy the notebooks to servers that are hosted at Max Planck Institute in Garching. Still, Docker also allows to install all the most common and used packages in data science and machine learning as Pandas, SQLearn, TensorFlow, and many others. You can access the AI toolkit from the nomadlab.eu website. In this page and in some of the others, we will find part of the text that is blurred. The reason is that I don't want you to focus on all the abundant details you can find the web page and tutorials that I'm going to show. On the other hand, you can currently find all the content that is available online. You can access the AI toolkit, and this will redirect to a list of tutorials that you can see now in little to the left of the slide. And this list is divided into three different sections according to the three different purposes of the AI toolkit. Now I'm gonna give an overview of a notebook that is contained in the section that is dedicated to the reproduction of published results. This notebook is concerned with the discovery of new topological insulators in alloy tetradamates, and it allows to reproduce results that have been published in a paper, and you can find from the AI toolkit a link that redirects to this paper. You can then access the AI toolkit with either a NOMAD account, and this will let you save and store results, or you can otherwise use an anonymous and immediate access. Now you can see at the left of the slide overview of the whole notebook, and then different parts of it are going to be zoomed in inside at the center of the slide. At the beginning, there is an introduction that explains the method and the applications described in this notebook. In this specific case, symbolic regression algorithm, namely SISO, is used to discern trivial versus topological insulators in a class of materials, the alloy tetradamates. Then below, you can find all the tools to run the simulations. You can modify the input parameters as you desire, or you can use a default selection that will allow to reproduce the results that have been published in the paper. If you run the algorithm, then this will clearly produce an output. And then you can use a visualizer for an interactive visualization of your results, as you can see now. In a nutshell, SISO finds some low-dimensional descriptors, which are interpretable And that allows to trivially discern, in this case, the two classes of materials, of insulators. And in this plane, this plot, as you can see, you can find different colors and symbols which represent the different classes of materials. And you can find that on this plane, that is this surface that is found by Sisso, these two classes of materials are geometrically separated. Each of the points represents a different material, and then you can inspect the molecular structure of these materials by clicking on any on those points. Still, the visualizer also allows to offer a number of tools to produce a high quality plots that would be ready for transparencies or even publications. As you can see, this plot here now was produced using the default selection. And in fact, it reproduces results that have been published in the paper that is associated to this notebook. Now, I would like to show you how to retrieve data from the NOMAD archive. You will start again from the nomadlab.eu website, where you can start exploring the calculations in the NOMAD archive. You can push a button that is now highlighted, and this will redirect to a graphical user interface that will allow you to make your selection to query the NOMAD archive. Then you can manually inspect the data set that you selected, or otherwise you can use snippet code to retrieve this data set into the AI toolkit to perform any sort of AI analysis. If you click a button that is highlighted in an icon bottom right of this other webpage, we'll show you a Python code. Then you simply have to copy paste the Python code in any of the tutorials, and this will retrieve the data set in the toolkit. This is possible through a Python client library that is maintained in our laboratory. We also maintain a notebook that shows an example of AI analysis on data retrieved from the NOMAD archive. I won't have time to give you an overview, a detailed overview of this notebook. Still, I just would like to mention that in this notebook, you will find the same visualizer that I shown before that will allow you to inspect the structure, the molecular structure of the data, the materials that you retrieved, and also to produce detailed plots as this one, where over 5,000 materials are on this plane, on this surface, that was found using a dimensional reduction technique that is HUMA. Here, the different colors represent different values of the atomic concentrations. The AI toolkit also offers a number of tutorials that guide for the most common machine learning methodologies, deep learning, random forest, kernel ridge regressions, and many others. These tutorials also have hands-on exercises to facilitate learning and some introductory videos that explain the goal of each tutorial. Differently from the many tutorials you can find online or available on the web, these tutorials are targeted for material scientists. And this means that the data sets that are used are mainly composed of material science data. Now, I would like to remark one of the missions of the AI toolkit, that is to promote reproducibility of published results. In fact, if you are a researcher working in the field of AI applied to material science, we invite you to contribute and share your methodology and your software that can be published in the format of a notebook in the AI toolkit to allow the production of your latest published results. We really care about this mission of the AI toolkit, as the existence of a platform that allows an immediate deployment of the latest methodologies used in our field would bring us to the next level of sharing. Still, in addition to being a great contribution to the scientific community, having a notebook published in the AI toolkit can help promoting visibility of your research and also reusability of your method. So please contact us if you wish to publish a notebook in the NOMAD AI toolkit. Now, I would like to thank, first of all, Luca Gringelli and Mattias Scheffler, who are the main persons behind the AI toolkit. And then I also would like to thank the many PIs, postdocs, and students who have been actively contributing and enriching the NOMAD AI toolkit. And now, thank you for the attention.